prison's been clear as shit today. It's blurry.
Hey, they're about to start serving food. $6 per person. Go around over there.
Chris is going to eat them.
Bob's going to eat them.
Chris is now going to eat them.
Hey, did you tell me I was
lying
in there?
No.
Did you win?
You won.
Yeah. Are you telling
me
you lost?
No. I said I'm not lucky yet. I shouldn't have won. He had to.
I'm sorry. Larry and Jordan, there's this course.
You said that's a
point. You won. Who cares?
Yeah.
My hell guess.
Larry Steele with the break. So right now we have Larry Steele and Jordan Wivell. Larry, Joe Norton tournament sponsor player. And the tournament director for the day. I'd like to thank Larry for having me out. Although we're not live streaming at the moment, we are recording. We'll post later. Larry's playing that six in the corner. Sits up nicely for the five. This is a race to seven. They're playing Masters format today. Draws over nicely. Uses that high ball to stop the cue ball. Sets up for the one. So going two rails here to set up for the three. Nicely done. Trick is you're just not going to want to get caught up behind that 14 ball. So you're going to have to let the cue ball either drift down under the 14 or you draw it back. Excuse me, not the 14, it was the 13, my bad. Right the first time, it is the 15. I'll get used to these streaming balls eventually. Plays the two to the three. Actually, that was the four. Two to the four. My, oh my. It sits up nicely for the two. Oh. Just caught a little too full. Jordan Wivell to the table. Thank you. Oh, so Jordan trying to follow, maybe to get to the long rail. I'm not sure why he wanted to do that. He probably could have just drew the ball back a little bit there and maybe played the 9, then set up for the 15. Maybe you're overthinking it a little bit. So Larry Steele to the table. Draws the cue ball off that long rail. Play the 8 ball probably in that top left corner pocket. All right, so Larry Steele takes the early lead, 1-0 of Jordan Wivell on a race to 7. This is the Punky King of Hagerstown, hosted and tournament directed by Larry Steele. We're out here at the Moose Lodge in Williamsport, Maryland. I'd like to say thank you to my sponsors, Lambros Q's, Money Shot Billiards, and Big Money Billiards. All right, so dry break by Larry Steele is going to bring Jordan Wivell to the table. Pretty open rack. Looks like Jordan's filling on that 3 ball there in the side pocket. These tables are playing a little slow, so you notice there that ball turned over. He was trying to hit that ball with draw. Cue ball just sort of rolled, turned over on him. A little slow. So you have to follow through with your stroke a little bit. Can't be poking it. So Jordan lining up that 1 ball. Rattles it. Ties up the 15 ball with the 6. So if you're Larry, you're trying to figure out how you're going to get that 15 ball free or how you can set up on a safe off of it. But not a whole lot of options to safe off the 15 there. So even with the 2 sitting down there in that bottom right-hand corner pocket, getting under the 15 is still a problem. You can't play the 15 in the bottom right corner. So man, look at that shot. Nicely done. Using that 14 ball, send it down table to free up the 15. Well done. Might even have the combination on here between to the 15 to the 14. So Larry taking a look at that combination. Safety play could be just to bump the 9 and try to get the cue ball over underneath the 8. Just like that. Well done. I think he wanted to be actually up a little closer to the 8 ball, but it's the right idea. Like that play. Jordan to the table. So Jordan actually looking pretty good here. He's got a nice angle into the five. Just needs to get the cue ball out towards the center of the table, I believe. High right running English will do that. Tables are slow. Just a little slow. Well, he's got his work cut out for him. Seven ball, if you can cut it in that top left-hand corner pocket, it'll probably give him a nice angle for the eight. Again, it's no gimme. Just hit it a little too thick. Larry Steele to the table. Pretty open pattern here. Probably, I would say, start off with the nine, then work down towards the bottom left corner pocket. Let's see what Larry has in mind. Now he's going to go down and take care of the 13 ball now, it looks like. That'll work too. Idea is to get those balls off that short rail. So now he's working down towards the 15. So take the 14 ball now. Nicely done. Now, you got to hit this ball with the top. That's the only thing he's got as an option, shooting off the rail. Don't want to get hooked behind the 7. I had a premonition. So we're playing Masters format rules, so it looks like the jump cue is coming out. And there it is. Going to call that 10 ball in that top right corner pocket. And Larry's coming right at you here. Nice effort. Uh-oh. I just think the folks are having a little bit of difficulty playing on the slower tables. The cue ball's acting a little different because they're not stroking through the ball. Maybe used to playing on slightly faster tables. So tied up, 1-1. Jordan and Larry. Jordan to break. Tied one game apiece. A race to 7. Pockets a ball. A lot of trust to slow roll a ball like that on a bar box, especially a bar box that gets moved around. They just brought these in, I think, last night. They did a great job getting them in here and getting them leveled. But still, you have to have a lot of trust in the table to be able to slow roll like that. Well done. Nice shot there by Larry to get on the top side of that three ball. Play it in that bottom right-hand corner pocket. Just maybe need to just draw that cue ball. Just a touch. Or you can bump into it. Try to run into that ball a little bit. Maybe that might be the play. A little bit of follow. Bump into that 10. Nope, just killed it. Good shot. So we'll play it in the side pocket. For the 2-1 lead. Nice shot. So Larry Steele leads 2-1 on a race to 7. My name is Wayne Everhart from ThinkTechMD. This is TTMD Billiard Streaming.
Thank you.
All right, so Larry Steele to break, leading 4-2. Drive break. Jordan Wivell to the table. Larry with a safety play. So I think if you're Larry here, you're just going to try to stop the cue ball right where the two's at. Got lots of balls there to hide behind. Send the cue ball, two ball down to the bottom rail. There you go, nice shot. So it looks like Jordan's going to try to play the two in the side pocket there. I don't know if he's calling the nine or the two in the side. We'll see. Ball in hand given. Sets up nicely for the three. Play the four in either the bottom side or up the top left corner. Excuse me, bottom left corner. Always going to go in the top right corner. Nice shot. Lots of options there. Just to follow a little too far, I think there. Looks like he hit himself from the five. Looking at possibly putting that cue ball behind the 70. Be careful, not hit too thick and scratching the side pocket. Nice shot. Yeah, it was a tough shot.
Yeah.
Jordan bringing that cue ball to rail, sets up for the seven. Just need to hit this ball with a little bit of draw, come back across table for the eight. Oh, got under it. That's the table's playing slow. You have to actually stroke these balls. If not, the cue ball's turning back over on you. So maybe try and bank this eight ball with a little bit of left. Help it out a little bit. It's going to be short. It's going to leave Larry with a shot in the top right corner pocket. Pockets the eight, sets up for the nine, the side. Larry takes a 5-2 lead over Jordan Wivell. Just joining us. My name is Wayne Everhart from ThinkTechMD. This is TTMD Billiard Streaming. We're out here in Williamsport, Maryland, the Mosse Lodge. Larry Steele to break. Dry break, Jordan Wivell to the table. Jordan can see the one. Two balls accessible after that. It's a nice angle. You can play the two ball in that bottom right corner pocket. Comes back across the table. Be careful not to scratch in the side. Might be a little straight on this three. So Jordan looking pretty good here. Trick might be the six ball. What's going to happen to the seven if you happen to hit it? So you got to plan for that. Nicely done. Oh, wow. Again, that's another example of just not stroking through the ball where the cue ball sort of doesn't take the draw like you want, turns over. That ball drifted way down the table. I'm sure Jordan was expecting to draw over towards the long rail, not even get to that side pocket. I mean, not even to get to that corner pocket. So Larry looking to go up 6-2. Taking advantage of a mistake there by Jordan. So Larry Steele on the hill. I'd like to thank Larry for having me out today. Covering the Punky King of Hagerstown. My understanding is that this is going to be an annual event. The winner of the tournament today will have a belt. I believe their name will be engraved on it. And they'll get to hold that for a year. Pretty cool. Larry Steele to break. Not the most effective break in the world. Jordan Wivell to the table. I'm not sure if that was a push. Nope, ball in hand given. Ball just caught that eight ball heading towards that corner pocket. So ball in hand. Issue might be the 5 and the 8, depending on how you deal with it here. Maybe you can draw into it now. Yeah, good try. Spins a cue ball nicely, get down table. Still a problem with the 5-8. See how Larry deals with it. Maybe thin off of the 5 and send the cue ball towards the top long rail. Maybe back down towards the short rail where he's at now. Play safe. Not sure if the 9 ball is in the way to just spin the cue ball that much. Yep, very similar shot. Oh, cue ball, the 5 ball just got free. I think he was expecting that 5 ball to stay down towards that short rail. Oh. A lot of people missing side pocket shots today. Is Larry going to play the 6 to the 8? I think so. Set up for that side pocket. All right, well done. Larry Steele takes his match 7-2. Over Jordan Wivell. My name is Wayne Everhart from ThinkTechMD. This is TTMD Billiard Streaming.